My dear students, we were talking about nuclear chemistry. There we were discussing mainly stability of the nucleus. We understood the factor which is influence on stability of the nucleus, and if it is unstable, then it undergoes certain nuclear transformation to become stable. So now the consequence of nuclear instability is radioactivity. Now let us discuss radioactivity. Before going to discuss radioactivity in detail, we must know some of the historical background of radioactivity. This radioactivity phenomena is discovered by a physicist, Henri Becquerel, in 1896. So it is an accidental discovery. So he kept a piece of uranium element in a cupboard, in a closed cupboard in which neither light or nothing which is enter into it. And he also kept photographic plate along with the uranium metal foil. There he found that the metal plate is affected by the light radiation which is emitted by uranium. So then he opened and he just see the metal plate. Then in the metal plate he found that, so it produces the image of the uranium foil. Then he started to think that I kept the uranium foil in a closed cupboard in which no light is enter into it, but the photographic plate is affected. So then he started to think that somewhere inside the cupboard itself a light is coming out from a source. So then finally he concluded that the light source is uranium emitting radiation. Then he coined that phenomena as radioactivity. There he observed was, so he doesn't apply any force, any electricity, he doesn't pass any light, but spontaneously without any external influence the uranium started emitting radiation. As a result the photographic plate was affected and so the image is printed on this. So this is an accidental discovery. Then later, and then after 1896, he started to do more research on this phenomena, and because of that this is also called as Becquerel rays. That is the radiation which is emitted from a radioactive element. So these are called as Becquerel rays, and the phenomenon in which the spontaneous emission of radiation by some elements, so this is called as radioactivity. So it can be defined as, so the radioactivity is a spontaneous emission. There are two words are very important while defining radioactivity. One is spontaneous emission and disintegration. You know the meaning of disintegration, that is something which is reducing. Integration means something which is addition. So disintegration is something here mass is decreasing in case of radioactivity. Why? Because the mass is converted into energy. The mass is converted into radiation energy. That's why the mass is decreases. This is called as disintegration. And this disintegration is spontaneous. So it doesn't require any external force. That's why the radioactive phenomena is defined as the spontaneous emission of radiation by disintegration of an unstable nuclei is called as radioactivity. So based on the nature of radiation emitted from different element, different unstable nuclei, the radioactivity can be classified into three types. So they are alpha decay. It is also called as decay. So we use the word decay. I think you know the general meaning of decay. We use this word decay in biological process, something which is undergo degradation, something which is subjected to a microbial activity. That is something which is reduces. So here also, the unstable nuclei convert into stable nuclei, so undergo nuclear transformation. So in this transformation, so they emit radiation, that is energy. So this energy is come from some amount of mass is converted into energy. So that's why it is called as disintegration. So based on the nature of particle emitted, it can be classified into three types. One is alpha decay, beta decay and gamma decay. So now let us see one by one in detail. Alpha decay, you know alpha particle. So generally helium nuclei is called as alpha particle, which contains two proton and two neutron in the nucleus. That is, its atomic number is 2 and mass number is 4, and it contain 2 neutron plus 2 proton. That's why, so this is called as helium nuclei. That means the disintegration, you just observe this reaction here, uranium 238. Dear students, in order to understand nuclear chemistry properly, you must know this notation, representation of an element with its mass number and atomic number. So usually if you consider X is an element, so generally we are going to represent its mass number at either in the left upper subscript, left upper subscript, or in the right upper subscript, we are going to represent mass number. In lower subscript, we are going to write atomic number Z, and here we are going to write mass number A. If you consider uranium, so uranium 92, 238, this is one of the radioactive element. So it is converted into thorium. Then in thorium, the mass number reduced by 4 units and atomic number reduced to 2 units, 92 to 90, 238 to 234, and it gives helium nuclei. That means the process of radioactivity, which involves elimination of alpha particle. So that's why this is called as alpha decay. And this decay process involves decrease in atomic number by 2 units. You just observe here. So here 92 becomes 90. That is decrease in atomic number of daughter nuclei by 2 units, mass number by 4 units. And in nuclear reaction, you must know another important thing is, in a nuclear reaction, in general reaction, we are called as reactant and product in normal chemical reactions. So you know the meaning of reactant and product. But in case of a nuclear reaction, so this is called as parent nuclei. The reactant nuclei is called as parent nuclei. So it is undergo radioactivity, it is undergo decay process. So this is parent nuclei. And after undergo nuclear transformation, it gives a product. So this is called as daughter nuclei. This is called as daughter nuclei, and this is called as ejectile. The byproduct is called as ejectile. So in this alpha decay, the ejectile is alpha particle. So as I said, alpha decay, it involves the radioactive disintegration, it involves so emission of alpha particles, or it is also called as helium nuclei, followed by decrease in its atomic number by 2 units and mass number by 4 units. So this is called as an alpha decay. Next, beta decay. In beta decay, it is going to eliminate a beta particle. A beta particle is nothing but, so here electron, a beam of electron is called as beta particle. So you just take these two examples through which you can understand the meaning of beta decay. Here, so C14, atomic number of carbon is 7 here, sorry 6. Atomic number of carbon is 6 and its mass number 14. So there are two kinds of beta decay. One is beta minus decay and beta plus decay. We just observe here C, C6-14, then it becomes, so nitrogen, so this is nitrogen of atomic number 7, mass number 14, and it gives one antineutrino, so, and it gives electron. So you just observe here atomic number in the beginning is 14, sorry, mass number is 14, and here also mass number remains same, but atomic number here is 6 and here atomic number is 7. So why atomic number is increases? That means one proton is increases. In case of beta minus decay, one neutron is converted into proton, one proton, plus it emits one electron and one antineutrino. So this proton will add up. That's why, so before the atomic number is 6, then it becomes 7. See, just here before there are 8 neutrons and here only 7 neutrons are present. That's why it is called as beta minus decay, because it involves an electron of it carrying a negative charge. So beta particle, that's why it is called as beta minus decay. Here atomic number increases because the neutron is undergo disintegration, converted into one proton, and it emits one electron. And in case of beta plus decay, just observe here also carbon of atomic number 6, but its mass number 10. So it has 6 proton and 4 neutron. So this carbon converted into boron of atomic number 5 and mass number 10. You just observe here, before it has 6 proton and 4 neutron.